I'm David Vaucher, and welcome to day 17 of my six-month life transformation chronicle. It turns out that because of the freezing weather, I think most of the buildings got their heating on, they're all home, and there's no power. But thankfully, I've got some juice left in the battery, and so we're just going to power through and give you this video for day 17. So as usual, hopefully the steps are going well. We're inching closer to day 21, which is that point at which all of these, behaviors that you're trying to get used to become habits. So hopefully you've seen some results and you're keeping moving forward. And as always, we'd love to hear how you're doing and the results you're seeing down in the comments section. So in terms of what I'm thinking today, I mentioned yesterday that I'm working on a Python project. I'm trying to visualize some data from the FractFocus database with the idea of just keeping my own skills sharp, but also having something useful to present to people that will serve as a little bit more of a technical business card for what it is I do. Now, the nice thing about doing that is that if you're by yourself, you get to claim all the credit and say, hey, this is fantastic, I did this. The bad thing is that when you're by yourself, the flip side is you also take all the blame, and it's very hard to have someone look over your work. So when it comes to data analysis in particular, you can rationalize any number, right? And so it's very easy to put something out there and say, hey, this is my answer. But if you have someone to bounce it off of, they might say, well, I've got this data point and it doesn't seem to gel very much with that. Or, hey, did you remember to do this operation? Because that's really critical and it will really skew your results. Because if they don't find it, if there's not someone else that will find it for you that you trust, someone else in the public will find out. And that's bad. I mean, that's an instant reputation and competency killer. So not having someone to bounce ideas off of is very hard. And I imagine it's probably the same for any field, right? I mean, a website, if you have a design partner, they might say, well, this looks really good, but I've found that clients really like it this way, or someone to help you proof your articles, anything, right? But in particular, for my own data analysis, it's really scary because some of the errors can be very insidious. And so I guess I'm just wondering how you guys handle having someone to validate and check your work before it gets released, right? Even, I know it's very dicey with a client. You never want to share data, but at the same time, is there some way that you can just in broad strokes find out whether or not you're on the right track before it shows up to the client and it's possibly wrong, right? That's the nightmare scenario. So in terms of what I'm thinking of doing, I've got some colleagues and contacts that I'm still on good terms with, and so I think that because what I'm doing is just off of public data, there's no secrecy issue there. There shouldn't be any problem just saying, hey, I'm working on this, it's in beta. What do you think? Does it look right? Do you have any suggestions for improvement? And so really, I'm just going to rely on goodwill and hopefully a little bit of a favor and asking for some time. In regards to the client stuff, if that ever comes up, I've got no choice. I'm just going to have to trust myself, triple check everything and hope for the best. But certainly for this public stuff, I want to make sure I can use as much of my network as possible to validate and get some early feedback before I go to market with it, so to speak. That's really, because I'm so deep into this, that's what's on my mind now is, fantastic, I get whatever good comes out of it, but my name's also on the line for whatever bad comes out of it. So that's what's going on. Just very quickly also, it looks like I might have another, free consulting assignment to build some goodwill with a potential client. Again, that's going to fall on me to get it right, but it's good to have engagement. I've got a call in about an hour, hopefully to secure my first job. Things are going well for now. I hope they're going equally well for you. We're in the middle of the week. I hope that it's going very well, that you're able to finish strongly. I want to remind you, as usual, to keep taking those steps towards your goals, and I will see you again on day 18 tomorrow. Thank you so much.